Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wen. Here is the question. N is a four-digit number equals A, B, C, D. If the following condition is true, this number plus the sum of its digit equals 1991. Can you find this number? That means, can you find what are A, B, C, and D? We rewrite the four-digit number in this way. The first digit A is in thousands location. So that's A times 10 to the power 3. B, that's hundreds. That means B times 100. C, that's tens. C times 10. D, that's ones times 1. So those A, B, C, D are single numbers from 0, 1, 2, till 9. Maximum value is 9. For this situation, A cannot be 0 because we said that's a four-digit number. So A only can be 1, 2, 3 until 9. Now look at the left-hand side. That's this number plus the sum of its digits. So here, look at here, just plug in N here for A, B, C, D. Look at here, we have similar items. We group them. For example, A, we have 1,000 A here. We have one more A here. B, we have 100 B here. We have one more B here. 10 C, we have one C. D and D. So group them. We have 1,001A, 101B, 11C, and a 2D. This equals 1991. From this part, we have the result A equals 1. Why? We already discussed A should be bigger than or equal to 1, cannot be 0, because A is a leading digit. That's a four-digit number, so A cannot be 0. So now, can A be bigger than 1? That means 2, 3. Look at a 2. If here's 2, that means the first term should be 2,000 and a 2. 2,000 and a 2 is bigger than the right-hand side, cannot be equal, because each item here that's bigger than or equal to 0 cannot be true. That is why A only can be 1. If A is 1, we already fixed the first number. And just to replace A by 1, simplify this expression. So move this term to the right-hand side. So right-hand side minus 1,001. Continue to simplify. We have this one. Move to the next page. So what do we have now? A equals 1. The first number equals 1, and we also have this one. So now we need to figure out the B. How to figure out a B? Consider the last two items. The last two items, 11C plus 2D, this is the up one. Why? This is a up bound for the sum of the two, because the maximum value for C is what? 9, the single digit. C, same situation for D. Replace C and D by 9, that's the maximum value the sum can reach. So 11 times 9 plus 2 times 9 equals 117. Do some basic algebra, we will get the inequality. So move the sum of 2 to the right-hand side. We have this. 101B equals 990 minus this sum. Because this part less than equal to 117. If we have a minus, if we substitute this by 117, we should change inequality sign because that's negative. So this should be bigger than or equal to 990 minus 117, which is 873. Simplify this. This one bigger than or equal to this one. Here is the simple form. Now look at here. What can we imply? This B should be 9. Why is 9? The maximum B value is 9. Cannot be lower than 9. If it is 8, what will happen? If it is 8, look at this inequality, if it is still true. If it's 8, 8 times 101, that's what? 808. 808 is not bigger than or equal to 873. So cannot be 8. Also, we can say that B cannot be below or equal to 8. So that's the reason why B equals 9. So now we find the second number. B equals 9. B equals 9. Simplify this one. We have two more parameters, C and D, to think out. So move this to the right-hand side. Simplify. 11C plus 2D equals 81. Now look at this situation. 2D is bounded by 18 and 0. So what's the maximum value for 2D? When D equals 9, 2 times 9 equals 18. That's the maximum value for 2D. The smallest value, D, can be 0. 2 times 0, that's 0. So 2D is in between 0 and 18. Move 2D to the right-hand side. The right-hand side, we can find the range, up bound and low bound for 11C, because we know the up bound and low bound for 2D. Same situation, negative here, we need change the inequality sign. What does this mean? 11C less than or equal to 81, 2D less than equal to 18. Here, greater than equal to 0. If we put the minus, it should be less than or equal to this minus 0. Same situation here, replace 2D by 18. Simplify two sides, left-hand side, right-hand side. You can see 11C is dominated by 81 and 63. Now here, we claim this C only takes value 6 or 7. So that this inequalities are true. We have two inequalities. So look at this one. C only can be below 7. So C equals 7 times 11 is 77. That's true. Now, can C be 8? 8 times 11, that's 88. 88 is bigger than 81. So cannot be bigger than 7. So look at the left-hand side. The lowest should be 6. 11 times 6 is 66. 66 is bigger than 63. That's true. Now, can C be lower than 6? That means 5. 5 times 11 is 55. 55 is not bigger than or equal to 63. So C only can take value 6 or 7. We consider 6 first, then consider 7. If C equals 6. Now here we have this equation here, replace 6 here. So we can solve this equation for 2D. Replace C by 6 imply 2D equals 81. 6 times 11, that's 66, equals 15. 2D equals 15. So D equals 15 over 2, which is 7.5. D is an integer, cannot be 7.5. So it is impossible. Impossible. What is our conclusion? C cannot be 6. C can be 7. Look at 7. If 7 is possible, if C equals 7, repeat the same procedure we did here for C equals 6. Replace C by 7. We solve this equation, we can find 2D equals 4. 2D equals 4, D equals what? D equals 2. So you can see we find the C equals 7 and the D equals 2. So far we have 4 digits. First digit, that's 1. Second digit, that's 9. Third digit, that's 7. Last digit, that's 2. In summary, we know N equals A, B, C, D. This 4-digit number is 1972. This is the answer. Thanks for watching and see you next time.